So what's the quality of your thinking when it comes to ability to believe that you have all it takes within you to make things happen? What is that thing that stimulates you, that tells you, wait a minute, it is difficult, but it's possible. It is challenging, but this too shall pass. That is the thinking of anybody who wants to make sustainable impact. Otherwise, this country, the things that are not working in this country, is enough to make you cry. Yeah? It's enough to do what?
Make you cry.
To make you cry. To lock yourself in house and you're crying at my age, I'm not accomplished. You cry. After crying, you go again, you eat you again. But the resolve that it doesn't matter what happens, I shall go through. It's a winning point. In fact, 50% of the job is done when a thought process is started. Number two, in terms of the thought patterns that you must think innovation. To be very honest with you, if your ideas, the ideas you are going to put in this document, are the ideas that we are almost used to, you know, the way most of the time they do budgets in this country is
copy
and what? You went to university with assignments. What did you do? Copy
and paste.
Copy and paste. If it has to be innovative, then it means that someone will have to think through and say, you know what? This has never been done before. But with our idea, it's something new. So we see into the future, make it happen. So it's your mind thinking in improving this thing, improving this process, improving this idea, making things happen differently, doing things differently. Is that what your mind, or is your mind thinking, so has it been done from the beginning up to today? You know, there are people who drive to a particular road on a daily basis. That's the road they pass. If they wake up from sleep, they get into their car, they pass through that road. Meanwhile, there are over five other routes. Do you know that anybody who has a self-innovation can say to their own path through this road? I just passed through the other road. It just shows you that that's the person's mindset. You can think different. The world is looking for innovators. The world is not looking for people who are just traditionally doing what they are used to doing. If this country must make progress, even with the electoral process, can I shock you? Even with the electoral process, young people have to come to a point in this country where they say, you know what? Look, enough of all these people coming to throw money at us. Right? I don't need this money. And young people can say, you know what? Just for innovation's sake, can all these candidates come and share their thoughts with us? Let's evaluate them. Where are they coming from? How did they make their money? Right? What are the qualities, the competencies that they have? What are their dissidents? When young people begin to think that way, what happens? It is innovation. Innovation is not only when you invent something new. Innovation is not when you discover something new. Innovation can be something as simple as changing the seating arrangement here just to allow for a new place of new thoughts. You can rearrange your room just for flow of thoughts. And that is, in itself, innovation. It has to. You can't succeed with what you want to do. I've heard all of you, the projects you want to do, they are all great projects. After all, sometime, maybe before I leave, I might even make some of you ambassadors, if not all of you. Right? But guess what? The work that you're going to do will not be done as by business as usual. It is when there's a sense of urgency, that's what creates a sense of what? Innovation. Can we, if we spend 3 hours doing this thing, can we spend 1 hour doing it? Right? Can we spend, go to the bank. You can provide a solution, a software that can stop people from just queuing unnecessarily. You can impact all the processes if you want to. In the work that you do, you can create something that can be innovative, that can change the entire. Today, my wife was ironing, and an idea just hit her. She just shared the idea with me, and I'm like, whoa, this is money smelling. This is what?
Money
smelling. And the idea was just very simple. Very simple. No plenty processes. Just something new that is not working. Sometimes you think too much. I have to say, everybody was there in the so, you must have seen company everywhere, right? People start thinking in that context. Meanwhile, we're wired differently. Do you know that this hall, in this room, there are people who can be social entrepreneurs? There are people who are intrapreneurs. There are people who are entrepreneurs. Right?
Yes.
Do I have social entrepreneurs here?
Yes.
Do I have intrapreneurs here?
Yes.
Do I have entrepreneurs here?
Yes.
What are you talking about? You are created differently. So in your process of innovation, it has to be something unique to you. Because you're all unique. That's the thing I'm talking about. Number three, you must think passion. You must think what?
Passion.
Passion. You must think what? Passion. Okay. Have you ever made a presentation to someone and the person says, oh my God, if I don't put money in this your project, I've seen some of the bankers, they come to my office and they want me to put money in their banks. Say, excuse me, sir. They have given me deadline. They have also given me target. Please, as a man who helps people, can you please help me? Otherwise, they will sack me. This is an adult making a presentation. A banker, and she thinks or he thinks by sounding that way, he or she gets my attention. But what happens is that instead of getting my attention, I'm like, what? I'm not Father Christmas. Right? Now that am I your uncle? The truth of the matter is that you would have done research on me. You would have done a proper research on me, and after the research process, what do? You come out with a presentation that comes to meet my need. I am interested in my own needs. So when you make a passionate presentation that hits on my need, what happens? A response comes from me that fits into. If you're in an orphanage, you have to find those who have passion for what? The orphanage. There are a lot of people who have passion for orphanage. Just by their calling. That's the way they design themselves. So you have to learn how, even in the research process, passion is in that process. So when you are doing your work, the outcome of your work shows that passion has gone through this work. You can't produce a document. You can't produce this document that will be a 100-year document without passion.
Yes.
The commitment that you show through passion says this document, the outcome of this document is a work of passion. The document that produced the Constitution of United States of America was not an ordinary document that was produced outside passion.